Hello guys, this is Revan from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 108.
YouTube will no longer be accepting ads related to alcohol, gambling, politics or prescription drug terms for its masthead ad slot, which appears at the top of the website and application. The Verge, the limitation on what kind of ads can appear in this slot will help leads to a better experience for users. The masthead slot is one of the first thing user can see when they open YouTube. So it understandable that keeping ads about drugs, alcohol and gambling out of it would make YouTube more inclusive for everyone. As for politics, it could help the platform avoid controversies like the one that arose when the President Donald Trump purchased a slot for 3 days during the 2020 elections. Realme GT 5G has been launched globally and it is expected to release in India. Some of the key specifications include a Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 5G processor and a 65W Super Dot charger. It has a 120Hz Super AMOLED full screen and it comes with a Sony 64MP triple camera. It comes in three color variants, that is Dashing Blue, Dashing Silver and the Racing Yellow. The Realme GT will start selling on June 21st with a 8GB or 128GB storage variant costing at €369 in the first 4 days of early bird offer, while the 12GB and 256GB storage will cost you around €499 on Amazon only during Prime Day until June 22nd. After the deals are over, the prices will be €449 or €599 with availability at all major retailers across the old continent. And Realme Watch 2 and Realme Watch 2 Pro were also announced during the event. The Realme Watch 2 Pro was first announced in Malaysia earlier this month, but this is the first time the company is showcasing the Watch 2. The two watches take over from the Realme Watch that was launched last year. They are distant from each other only in the screen size and battery size and a few other features. The Realme Watch 2 Pro features a bigger 1.75 inch display with a resolution of 320 x 385 pixels. The Realme Watch 2 is designed for users who prefer a smaller compact smartwatch as it features a 1.4 inch display with a resolution of 320 x 320 pixels. The two display output the same 600 nits peak brightness. However, the Watch 2 Pro has a bigger 390 mAh battery capacity which can last up to 14 days on a single charge despite the higher resolution and a screen size. On the other hand, the Watch 2 has a standby time of 12 days. As for the pricing and availability, the Realme Watch 2 Pro will retail at €54.99, that is $67. While the Watch 2 Pro is priced at around €74.99, that is $91. The smartwatches will be available from June 16th and will be sold on Realme.com and Amazon. The Watch 2 Pro is available in two color variants, namely Space Gray and Metallic Silver, while the Watch 2 will be available only Space Gray color variant. Along with the other products, Realme has launched their TechLife Robot Vacuum, the brand's very first vacuum cleaner. The Realme TechLife Robot Vacuum has a similar design to a lot of robot vacuum cleaners on the market. It comes in black with a yellow accent for the LiDAR system. Realme has packed the vacuum cleaner with a high precision sensor, 38 in total, to help the measurement and collision avoidance. The LiDAR system allows it to smartly map and navigate around the home. According to the product page, you can store up to 5 maps on the device, partition and name areas of the map, and also customize the type of cleaning you want to do for these areas. So if you want a deeper cleaning for areas such as kitchen and you can configure it to do so. There is a 5200 mAh battery inside the Realme TechLife Robot Vacuum, which Realme claims that it will provide up to 300 minutes of cleaning time. Once the battery is low, it will return to the charging dock. A full charge takes up to 3 hours. The Realme TechLife Robot Vacuum has a price tag of €299. It will be available for pre-order starting tomorrow on the Realme website and AliExpress. Realme is also running a competition where one lucky winner selected every day from June 16th to June 25th will be able to purchase a vacuum cleaner at a discount price of €199. During the launch event of Realme GT in Europe, the company had one more thing moment, teasing two of its upcoming products, the Realme Book and Realme Pad. As the name implies, it is looking to announce its first laptop and its first tablet. The Realme Buds Q2 truly wireless earbuds were launched a couple of months prior in Pakistan and have also made available in certain other markets like Malaysia and many more. But a recent leak revealed that the company will be launching the new budget true wireless earbuds in India soon, and the price is expected to arrive around 2499 Indian rupees, that is roughly around $34. Realme X9 has been spotted listed on Realme India website. This handset will come as a successor to the Realme X7. Realme X9 price and specifications has been tipped. TCL is now gearing up for the another brand new smart mini LED TV launch in India. The company will be launching mini LED TV C series on 30th June 2021 at 12 PM. TCL has sent out media invites for the launch of its mini LED TV. Mini LED TV is claimed to feature industry leading quantum dot technology with over 100% color volume. It also promises to be an excellent value for consumers seeking high quality interactive home entertainment experiences. The new Razer Blade 14 comes with an AMD Ryzen 9 processor. This laptop can be configured with up to an NVIDIA RTX 3080 graphic card and a 165Hz 14-inch display. This laptop is priced at $1,799 and it is available for purchase in several regions today. Last month, OnePlus CEO Mr. Petlu confirmed that the company will soon launch the Node N200 5G, which will be exclusive to the US and Canada market. He didn't reveal the launch date, but the smartphone has been listed on B&H Photos website with official looking images and a price tag of $239.99. The official Poco India account said the camera issue has been reported by less than 0.2% of the total population. Nevertheless, they apologized to those affected. Below is a procedure to follow to fix the issue. Step 1. Clean camera app data. To do this, open settings, search manage apps, then search camera, clear data and clear all data. Second step is reboot the phone and third step is check the camera if it is working. The solution may not work for everyone and Poco knows that, which is why it is asked those who still face the issue to report it on the service and feedback app and upload the device logs under the camera section. The services and the feedback app is an amongst the pre-installed application and can be found in the app drawer. Jio has introduced a Jio Fiber postpaid service in India for the convenience of its users. Basically, Jio Fiber users will be able to continue using their broadband service without having to worry about the bill due date. The newly launched Jio Fiber postpaid option will be available for all the existing Jio Fiber plans starting from ₹399 per month. Please check out the image for the Jio Fiber plans price list. According to the reports, the worldwide smartphone market will grow 12% in 2021, with the shipments reaching 1.4 billion units. This represents a strong recovery from 2020, when shipments fell 7% due to the market constraints caused by COVID-19. As vaccine rollout continues around the world and the pandemic is subdued, component supply will emerge as a new bottleneck for the smartphone industry. Professor Yazami claimed that his company has realized the world's fastest lithium battery fast charging technology. According to his report, the charging capacity is 7 times faster than Tesla's fast charging. The traditional charging method adopts constant current charging. The charging circuit controls the current at the very beginning and it switches to constant voltage charging towards the end of the charging process. However, the new method is called as nonlinear voltammetry. Here, the current changes in the pulses throughout the process. He claimed that this method is the same as going up for the step. The voltage of each charging stage is kept constant until it reaches the next voltage after certain parameters are met. And it is finally full. This method allows the battery to take a short break during the charging process. Furthermore, the chemical reaction is significantly different from constant current charging. This fast charging technology can reduce the pressure on the battery to extend the life. It will probably extend the life of the battery pack of electricity vehicle from 5 years to 10 years. Hyundai Motor and General Motors said on Monday that they are pushing ahead with developing flying cars with the South Korean company, expressing optimism it would have an air taxi service in operation as soon as 2025. The GM executive said that it would take until 2030 for air taxi services to overcome technical and regulatory hurdles to reach commercialization. The zero-emission aircraft, which will take off and land like helicopters and carry passengers and cargo, and are being developed by a number of startups as well as aircraft makers and automakers, but they face a long road to profitability. Jio has started its 5G field trials in Mumbai. It has used indigenously developed equipment for Mumbai trials. For the 5G trials in other cities, it will collaborate with Samsung, Nokia and Ericsson for the hardware. Xiaomi is apparently working on a new smartphone that sports a unique design. A new patent has revealed that the device features a side-mounted fingerprint scanner that is housed on a curved display. This patent was filed back on 3rd June 2021 and showcases a smartphone with an edge-to-edge curved display. In other words, the device might be a premium-grade flagship model. One of its most notable features include a side fingerprint scanner that is housed on the right side where the screen is curved. MIT researchers have created the first fiber with digital capabilities able to sense, store, analyze and interfere activity after being sewn into shirt. Yuval Fink, who is a professor of material science and electrical engineering, a research laboratory of electronic principal investigator and the senior authority on the study, says digital fiber expand the possibilities for fabrics to uncover the context of the hidden patterns in the human body that could be used for physical performance monitoring, medical inference and early disease detection. After months of rumor, it seems more and more assured that Samsung will not release a Galaxy Note this year. But the 2022 model could impress. The new images reveal a possible design for the Galaxy Note 21 Ultra, which could conquer millions of users. Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 4 has been spotted on the FCC platform. Galaxy Watch Active 4 and Galaxy Watch 4 are expected to launch on June 28. The Galaxy Watch Active 4 Wi-Fi and LTE models have appeared on FCC. Qualcomm will abandon TSMC to join Samsung and thus take advantage of its 4-nanometer lineup, which apparently will result in cheaper processor as well as larger quantity of products. After all, Apple now owns the mistress the vast majority of TSMC production quote, so many partners had to jump the boat. That's exactly why Nvidia is with Samsung, not TSMC. According to the new leak, the Snapdragon 895 has already been tested by several smartphone manufacturers, revealing a slight performance increase over the current Snapdragon 888 processor. It's too early to be sure of the performance of the new processor, but it is increasingly obvious that the speed of processor is not an issue. Therefore, Qualcomm should focus more on processor efficiency. After all, it is in the battery life that many of the user complaints reside. A new report by Display Supply Chain gives us a glimpse of what to come in the foldable smartphone segment. And the most interesting part is that Honor is readying a foldable handset of its own, likely called as Magic Fold. A new leak has revealed that the Honor Magic 3 smartphone will arrive with Snapdragon 888 Pro processor. The device will apparently launch in August 2021 and will feature the new top-end processor from Qualcomm. Android users can now stream high bitrate audio on the latest beta version of Apple Music. Users can stream 24-bit music via the application. The update also adds crossfade and improves the search functionality in the library. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.